Hello, this is Hiroshi Yamazoe. In this time, I'm gonna talk about what I have learned from interacting with many foreign Hikikomori people over the internet. In the past, I was thought that Hikikomori were something that existed only in Japan. But in around 2002, a psychologist revealed on an internet program that there were many Hikikomori-like people in foreign countries as well. Through this, I learned that there are Hikikomori in foreign countries as well for the first time. Later, through some books, I learned that there are many Hikikomori, especially in countries with strong family connection in tradition, such as Confucian countries like South Korea and Japan, and Catholic countries like Italy. And after that, I learned that in fact, Hikikomori are not particularly uncommon in countries other than those within Confucian and Catholic countries as well. I found out that Hikikomori are not uncommon in all over the world from information on the internet and books and messages I received from many people through SNS, YouTube, and Discord. So actually, Hikikomori are not uncommon in many countries around the world. And nowadays, the word Hikikomori included in famous English dictionaries as well, and is gradually becoming universal word. And I have been interacting with many Hikikomori from all over the world through this YouTube comments and the global Hikikomori community that I started last year by Discord. The first thing I noticed is that many of Hikikomori around the world, including Japan, have similar tendencies. Many of the Hikikomori in around the world love subcultures such as games and animes and have had traumatic experiences in their relationships with people, such as being bullied in their school, and they want to somehow change the state of Hikikomori. Of course, there are some Hikikomori who do not fit into these tendencies, but based on these broad tendencies, I thought that the Hikikomori in other countries are very similar to the Hikikomori in Japan. But of course, there are differences in the living environment and culture of each country in the world. Unlike in Japan, the problem of illegal drugs is common in other countries. In other countries, there tends to be a very close relationship between Hikikomori and illegal drugs. In particular, hard drugs such as heroin and methamphetamine have a serious negative impact on those users. Also, in some countries, social security is not sufficient. In such cases, some Hikikomori become homeless if they are kicked out of their homes by their parents. So, unlike in Japan, foreign Hikikomori live in a relatively harsh environment. Many of them are struggling to survive on their own. They have to be very, really strong to survive. I think there is a lot to learn from them. And I found something interesting from a different point of view. Hikikomori has been a social problem in Japan since about 20 years ago. Despite various social efforts to address this issue, the number of Hikikomori in Japan has been increasing continuously. And now in the world, people are experiencing lockdowns, remote works, and job losses during the COVID-19 crisis. I learned from YouTube comments and messages I received in my community that many people have become hikikomori because of this crisis. It seems that the number of hikikomori around the world is increasing as well, not only Japan. And then I realized something. Perhaps hikikomori are the people who live on the cutting edge of the world. In Japan, the word otaku was used as an insult and discrimination until around the millennium. Until then, otaku were the minority, but now otaku are major players all over the world. So there is no need to be ashamed of being a otaku anymore. It was like the early Christians who were persecuted by the Roman Empire. So maybe one day hikikomori will become a major player in this world as well. And it is logically reasonable too, because being a hikikomori is also the most efficient way to live. You can work in your room using your PC and do your shopping online. So you don't need to spend time, fuel, resources or money on commuting or going to shopping. It is the most efficient way to live in a world where technology is fully developed. So hikikomori in the world may be on the cutting edge of the future, leading the way for the future of mankind. However, when we are a hikikomori, it becomes difficult to make relationships with others. This may lead to suffering, loneliness, and other problems. And the current environment is not good enough to get a stable job as a hikikomori. In fact, in my community and YouTube channel, there are many people who say they want to get out the hikikomori state. So I cannot say that being a hikikomori is a good thing in the current situation. And by the way, as I said in another video, I'm working on a project to visualize the real stories of hikikomori from around the world. I have collected 11 stories from them through my community. They are very serious stories. I appreciate the people who have provided these stories. These stories are very detailed about the inner thoughts and experiences of them. Through these stories, I think you can get a detailed picture of them, and it will also give us new insight into about the hikikomori. So I am sure that the visualization of these stories will be very beneficial to people in Japan and around the world as well. The film is in English, but Japanese subtitles will be provided as well. This film is a big project with 11 stories, so it will take about 2 or 3 months from now to complete. And when the film is completed, I will release it on this YouTube channel completely free. I will do my best to make people who see this film will be inspired something, and that the people involved in this film will be happy with it. Thank you.